Hey everyone, welcome back to our video series. Today I want to talk about casing clearances and, you know, will a simple pump fit on my well? Let's talk about two different situations. First, let's talk about a well that doesn't have an electric pump in it, and then we'll talk about a well that does have an electric pump in it. So a well that doesn't have an electric pump in it, we can fit a simple pump in a 2-inch casing or bigger, as big as you can think of. Our middle cylinder, the 125, is 1¾ inches in outer diameter, so it will fit down a 2-inch casing. A lot of sandpoint wells in areas where there's very shallow water use 2-inch casing, no problems there, so 3-inch casing, 4-inch casing and up. So very few limitations in regards to when you have a well casing with no electric pump in it. Now when you have an electric pump, it's a little bit more complex, but still fits the majority of well casings out there. If you look at something smaller than a 4-inch, so that would be a 3-inch or a 2-inch that utilizes some kind of electric pump, then a hand pump's not going to fit. You may have the ability, based on the static water level, to utilize one of our suction pumps, which can be tied into the submersible line. So not everything is lost in that small of a casing when you have a pump installed, because that option might fit you. But when looking in 4-inch casings and larger, you can use a simple pump right next to your electric pump. There are some limitations in your 4, 4½-inch casings, and that's if your submersible pipe is larger than 1¼-inch pipe. So 1¼-inch pipe, which is measured based on the inner diameter of the pipe, so it's about 1.65 inches outer diameter. That or smaller, so a 1-inch pipe, will allow for a simple pump to be installed in a 4 or 4½-inch casing. When you look at a 5-inch casing, you can have as big as a 1½-inch submersible pipe, and our simple pump will still fit in there. Now if you go to a 2-inch and a 5-inch casing, 2-inch pipe and a 5-inch casing, there just isn't enough space. But when you get to the 6-inch casing and above, then there's plenty of space, whether it's a 2-inch submersible pipe, 1½, 1¼, or 1-inch, then there's plenty of clearances for us to install a hand pump in. Now there are a couple of exceptions when looking at pitless adapters. So when you have a pitless adapter, what that means is that your submersible pipe actually exits through the casing below ground. And the reason that's set up that way is because it freezes where you are, and you want to get the water out and keep it underground below that freeze line so that you don't have freeze issues. There are a couple of different types of pitless adapters that actually allow no passage of anything through the casing. There's a T-bar, and we've got pictures on our website that show the ones that don't apply. But there's one that has a bar across the top of the casing because it actually rests on that bar, which covers up too much of the casing, doesn't allow you to install a hand pump. And there's a couple of other pitless adapters that actually are down lower, but they cover the entire, you know, the entire area of the casing where they're installed. Which means there isn't the, you know, 1½ inches or 1.6 inches, I mean, or 1.8 inches for the 125 cylinder, or definitely not the 2½ inches required for the 200 cylinder. So I think the short story is most likely it will work in your well. There are some exceptions which I've discussed, but if you are uncertain or you have any questions about it, don't ever hesitate to give us a call, and we'll talk through it and look at pictures and figure out whether or not it'll work for you. Thank you.